antiviral compound blocks COVID-19 virus from entering cells. Researchers are continuously looking for any compound that can be used to treat COVID-19. At Washington University School of Medicine in St. Louis, a team developed a chemical compound capable of interfering with key features of many viruses. They are now working hard to figure out its potential against SARS-CoV-2. But before we continue, please like this video if you find this informative and subscribe to our channel for more interesting and informative content. Don't forget to click the bell icon too to get the latest updates. Published in the journal PNAS, researchers developed the MM3-122 compound. In cell and animal studies, the compound seemed to hold promise as a new way to prevent COVID-19 or reduce its severity. However, the interim results could only be observed during the early stages of infection. Great vaccines are now available for SARS-CoV-2, but we still need effective antiviral medications to help curb the severity of this pandemic, said senior author James W. Janetka. The new compound was observed with blocking potential on TMPRSS2 and a related protein called matriptase. TMPRSS2, or transmembrane serine protease 2, is a protein needed by coronaviruses to enter and infect human cells. Matriptase, meanwhile, is found on the surface of many cells, including lung cells. Influenza, SARS-CoV-2, and many other viruses depend on these proteins to attack cells in the lungs. When a virus attaches to a host cell in the airways, the TMPRSS2 cuts the spike protein. This practically gives permission for the virus to begin infection. But MM3-122 blocks the activity of TMPRSS2 to axe the infection process. With that, the virus fails to use the cell's machinery to make more copies of itself. Researchers said that in cells infected by SARS-CoV-2, the new compound gives better protection from viral damage than a COVID-19 treatment approved by the FDA. When they tested for acute safety in mice, the compound was not seen to cause obvious issues in large doses for a week. Besides COVID-19, the same compound could put a stop on SARS, MERS, and influenza viruses. Right now, the compound is in the infancy stages, so don't expect it to come out anytime soon. Several trials will be needed to confirm its safety and effectiveness. Hopefully, we get to that point so more people can have access to COVID treatments. What's your take on this new compound? Do you think it will pass clinical trials? Share your thoughts in the comment section. Till our next video, thanks for watching.